presentation to focus on flu risk. H1N1 strain expected to hit hard again this fall, although the virus seems to have hit a lull. Officials said outbreaks are occurring in the southern hemisphere where it's currently flu season and are expected to crop up here in the fall. It's not that we're wondering when the virus will show up. Marshall says it's here. It's here. High-risk groups, including pregnant women, healthcare workers, and children, will be treated first. Your kids and pregnant women are going to take the shot full of mercury and hell first. First. Silverton Hospital has held a couple of mass vaccination drills in the last couple of years. As soon as they get the vaccination out, we'll bring the mass vaccination program in here and start vaccinating the priority groups. And the children are the priority. Your calls after this. It's the Info Warrior. Ooh, they're real white and blue. We are back. It's the Info Warrior with Jason Burmes. Little CCR on the radio. Man, I love this. I'd like to get some Fogerty in my life before he goes. That's a band I haven't seen that I really would love to see. I know CCR is no longer together and the brother's dead, but I'm sure John Fogerty puts on a hell of a show. If anybody knows about any Fogerty in Texas, get at me on my websites. That'd be great. All right, I promise I go to your calls. 888-201-2244. Van in Texas, you're on the air.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hey, I have a question. Jason, I was just wondering if you found it easier to make a living riding Dylan Avery's coattails or Alex Jones's?
Well, I just wonder what you do for a living, sir. I haven't rode anybody's coattails. I've been doing this long before I knew Dylan Avery or Alex Jones. For free. And I would do it for free and continue to do so. I am my own individual human being, and I'm sorry that you feel that way.
You talk on your own show. That's a
really, because I think Alex came in twice, and I say whatever I want on my own show, and I let callers say whatever they'd like. You got a point,
like you
or
listen to whatever.
So, what do you do for a living, sir? What do you do for a living? I want to know what you do that's so great.
I promote movies called The Alex Jones Deception.
All right, bye. See you later. I'm glad that you do that. That's great. So, in other words, you do whatever you can to tear down other people's work because you're such an insignificant human being that nobody wants to listen to you. Appreciate the call. Let's go to Gayton in Canada. Gayton, you're on the line.
Oh, hi, Jason. How's it going?
Good, man.
Yeah, it's nice. I like the speech of that guy before.
Whatever, man. You just got to run with what you can do.
That's cool, man. You know what? I want to talk to you today about Canada's Homeland Security, all right?
Okay. What's that department called, by the way? It's not Homeland Security. It's something else, isn't it?
Say that again?
I said it's not called Homeland Security in Canada, is it? It's got a different department name?
Yes, somewhat, really. Well, I'm saying Homeland Security for everybody to know, really, whoever listens to the show, really. I come from a different background, I guess. I gotta say, I used to sell drugs and stuff, and I saw a really big evolution in Homeland Security in Canada, you know? And, mm-hmm. I've been approached by police officers, actually, and to work for them. And what they told me before, you know, it's to buy drugs from them, to steal it from people, and to call them, okay?
So wait a minute, are they trying to have you go after actual drug dealers, or are they going after marijuana? Because to me, that's a totally separate issue. What are they going after? Go ahead.
Actually, I'm going to tell you something, all right? That, a bunch of friends of mine I was dealing drugs with before, you know, all turned in, you know, like they all actually took the deal from the cops, you know? They were actually... the cops were offering a lot of money, like a career or something. The details, I'm not exactly sure because it's quite secret, you know. Nobody really wants to talk about it, you know. Like, but it's a major scale, man. You know, the bunch of people, you know, turned in and are working for the cops, really. And
I'm kind of not following here. Are you telling me that the cops are the ones dealing the drugs through surrogates? Or are you telling me that the cops are using these surrogates to make drug busts?
Actually, they're infiltrating the streets, man. You know, they're like putting people in the streets, you know, like on watch. You know, like drug dealers and criminal minds. You know, like people that are fast. You know, that can tell people from you know, like that are experienced with crimes. Someone that's got like more of a criminal mind. You know, like that can read body language and read criminals. You know what
I mean? Well, Gayton, I got to tell you, this doesn't seem like something new. I mean, and I thank you for the call. This has been going on in the United States for years and years and years and years. I mean, obviously, they recruit criminals all the time to rat out other criminals. It's a criminal culture. They know that somebody, you know, who they catch with a half ounce of pot in a certain area that's going to do 6 months to a year and has never done any time is going to rat out their bigger dealer. Then they go to the big dealer and he doesn't have a quarter ounce of pot. He's got a quarter pound of pot. Oh no, anything but that. But he's also got a little ecstasy too. Uh-oh, he's got ecstasy pills. Well, then he's going to rat out his guy. And such until they actually get to the government drug dealers, and then they stop because they say, hey, that's where we make our block ops money. And then they get a couple of the higher level drug dealers who, you know, are really just mid-level criminals to serve in their privatized prison institutions to feed the system at 39 cents an hour to call you up so you can change your phone service from AT&T to Sprint. I mean, that's the reality, okay? Schwarzenegger's talking about releasing, I think, 40,000 prisoners or something like that in the California prison system. That really surprises me that they just don't build another one and move them there. I'm kind of shocked at that. I don't know if that's a PR move, if they really are becoming too crowded, what that's all about. If you got an opinion on that, I would love to hear it. We're going to continue to take your calls, 888-201-2244 on the other side, and I'm going to hit up this Common Sense 2009 article. It's The Info Warrior with Jason Burmes. You can hit me up over at Facebook.com/TheInfoWarrior or MySpace.com/JasonBurmes, streaming live right now over at PrisonPlanet.tv.